Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We look at the SGI graph that I discussed in the previous update, and now with the seismic activity that actually occurred, magnitude 5.6 and larger, and we see a cluster at the beginning with the planetary geometry involving Venus. These are the purple peaks on the 17th and on the 19th, and we see a cluster there of stronger earthquakes peaking 6.2 at Shikoku, Japan. And then we had the critical convergence of three planetary conjunctions on the 21st involving Mercury. These are the red peaks, the high red peak later on the 21st. And we see right after this geometry occurred, an obvious cluster of stronger earthquakes peaking 6.1 in Taiwan. And this is a series of aftershocks of the 7.4 magnitude earthquake that happened in Taiwan on the 2nd of April. But the timing of this cluster is impeccable, obviously. We had a full moon on the 23rd. And also a lunar peak, a high lunar peak, that's the green peak on the 25th. So far, no stronger seismic activity, nothing 5.6 and larger. But this lunar geometry, the lunar conjunctions with Jupiter and Uranus on the 25th, that deserves some attention because there is a slight possibility that the anticipated larger seismic activity may occur about two and a half days after that lunar peak. So that will be later on the 27th or on the 28th. And there could be some strong seismic activity following this lunar geometry, especially because we did not have a larger seismic event with the critical planetary geometry so far. So let's have a look at the next SGI graph up until May 5th. We have some interesting planetary geometry coming up on the 28th and 29th, a near convergence of some interesting planetary geometry, two right angles and a planetary conjunction. That's Sun, Mercury, Saturn, 90 degrees on the 28th, followed by Earth, Mars and Neptune in a conjunction. This can result in a strong shake, possibly mid to high 6 magnitude, and that will be followed shortly after by Venus, Earth and Mars also in a right angle. Let's have a look at the solar system, how that geometry looks like. We see Earth in a conjunction with Mars and Neptune on the 29th. We see the right angle with Mercury, the Sun and Saturn, and also Venus at the right angle with Earth and Mars. And this geometry combined can result in an obvious cluster of stronger earthquakes, and there could be a stronger shake, like I said, in the mid-six, high-six magnitude range, maybe even magnitude 7, not sure about that. Then we have a pair of semi-right angles involving Venus, Mercury and Neptune on the 1st of May. And let's have a look at the solar system, how that geometry looks like. This is interesting geometry. Mercury 45 degrees with Venus and Neptune, and also Venus with 135 degrees with Mercury and Neptune. In a rare case, this can result in a major earthquake. Usually we see a cluster of stronger earthquakes, some seismic response, 5.6 and larger, but in a rare case, this can result in a larger seismic event. Then we have another right angle coming up, Sun, Mercury, Neptune, that's on the 4th, and that happens at a time that will be a series of lunar conjunctions. We had the lunar conjunctions with Jupiter and Uranus yesterday, and there will be no lunar conjunctions until the 3rd of May. Check out the website for the latest updates. Also, the atmospheric fluctuations, they can indicate approximately where a seismic increase may occur. We also share this in the social media, so be sure to check out those updates. This is the planetary and seismic update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.